everybody. Welcome to the second edition of the Beans and Weenie Backyard Gourmet with me, Scooter, and hopefully later on today, Spanky. We're going to get things rolling here in a minute, and you know today we talked about doing the perfect burger. So let's go ahead and get started.
So just a little tip from Casa de Scooter. When you're grilling or you're barbecuing, a couple of things that you need to definitely take care of. You need to clean your grill, plain and simple. Clean it up, clean the grates, and then oil it back up so you don't get any of that rust on there. Now, it's going to happen. It's going to rust a little bit because it's outside, unless you're one of those people that kind of keep your grill garage kept. But you clean it up, oil it back up so you get that good flavor from what you're cooking and you're not tasting what you cooked 3 weeks ago.
All right, now we get to the crux of everything. And before we go forward, I want to give a little shout out because I've got my production crew with me. And actually, that just means that Scooty is with me here. So they're holding the camera for us and hopefully they'll do a good job. I don't know how you can make, you know, this look bad, but we'll see what we can do. But anyway, we're talking about the best burger in the world and that's what we're working on. So for the best burger, you evidently need some hamburger meat. Now, I told you in the first episode that I like to go with the 73-27 mix. I want a little bit higher fat content because the fat actually helps season the burger and keeps it moist. You go with that higher muscle content, 80-20 or so on and so forth, and it just gets chewy. Tastes like a hockey puck. But anyway, so I've got me a nice mix of meat here, and I got this from my butcher at our local Research. Thank you, Research, for supplying this to us at a pretty penny. But anyway, so what we're going to do is we're going to take our meat. We're going to get it in our mixing bowl, all right, a big old chunk of meat. So we're going to be doing enough for all the Spankettes. There's like 27 of them, Scooty, myself, Mr. and Mrs. Spanky, so we can do a good taste test. Now, before we get started, a couple of things. A tip I learned is that heat, while you're mixing up your spices, is not good. The heat in your hands will break down the fat content in this hamburger. So it'll make it dry and it won't taste as good as what you want it to. So the key is, I know this is not something you always hear, but don't play with your meat too much. That's all I'm saying. Just don't do it because you break it down, it won't taste good. So with this first batch, we're gonna make two batches of hamburgers here. We're gonna go through making the patties and everything. The other side of the coin is, I wanna throw out here, keep your hamburger cold. So once you get it finished mixing it up with your spices, you put it back in the refrigerator, let it cool down, absorb those spices and everything. So this first bunch we're gonna do, this is gonna be a tame kind of burger. So I've got some spices here, some of my favorites. This is smoked paprika. Now, anybody know where paprika comes from? I'm gonna share it with you. Paprika comes from the cayenne pepper. So, and there's different levels of spice and intensity with the paprika. Now, I like the smoked paprika because they actually fire roast those peppers and then they turn it into this beautiful smoky flavor that comes in this paprika. And the other thing, my favorite of all time spices, it's a mixture. And this is gourmet garlic pepper. Now you saw me use it when I was caramelizing those onions because it's just wonderful, beautiful taste and you got to get some pepper in there and get some spices. Then I've got some kosher salt here. I'm going to be using some kosher salt just to give it a little flavor. Now in this, now it's not everybody's cup of tea, but in this batch I'm going to use a combination of green peppers or green onions, not green peppers, green onions. We're not making a meatloaf. And white onions, minced up. So I'm gonna get those mixed in there as well. So we're gonna get started. And the other thing that you can do is if you want a little smoky taste to it, you ain't got time to smoke the burger over charcoal and wood, you can put a little bit of smoke flavoring in it. And that's always good. I do cheat and use that on occasions. It comes in all different flavors, hickory, whiskey. Now, the all-time favorite that you have to add in is just a couple teaspoons of your whatever this sauce is. I can't pronounce it. Worcestershire. Hey, there's Scooty. What is that again? Say it.
Worcestershire
sauce. So a little bit of that. Now, everybody gets all up in arms about measuring stuff. You know, a tablespoon of this, a teaspoon of that, a pinch of this. You know what? I just say put it in until it looks good and have fun with it. So we're going to start off. We're going to get us a little bit of smoked paprika in here, get it all over the meat. Boy, this covers it all pretty like in there in the bowl. All right. Then we're going to get us some garlic pepper. Here we go. A little pepper on the garlic. Get that turned over. Get it on the meat. All right. Just for fun, just a little bit of kosher salt. There we go. Now, great thing is, we're going to do some green onions. Get them all mixed in there. Don't need all of them. And we're going to do some minced onions. A lot of the recipes you see out there call for onion powder or bottled onions or things like that. And I just, I don't go for it. Now, we're going to get this all going, get it mixed in. We don't want to handle the meat too much. You're not going to hear me say that too often, so pay attention. You don't want to handle the meat too much. We're just going to get it all turned over. Uh-oh. If some of it escapes, just reach in there and grab it. Put it right back. Don't worry about it. All right, so let's get it all mixed up good here. Get everything in the center. Mix it around. Kind of like you're, shuffling a deck of cards. Shuffle it all around. Now, the higher meat content you got, the better this is going to stick together. There. Okay. Now, I learned a little trick also, just to show that you haven't played with your meat too much. Now, this is a big trick. Now, when you get finished mixing everything up, what you do is you take a little piece, about the size of a quarter, maybe a little less, and put it in your hand, smash it, turn it over. And if it doesn't drop off, if it sticks to your hand, then that's time to put the meat up. You played with it too much. But if it drops off like it just did, you can continue to work with it. Now, we're going to get this all mixed up good. Like. Get rid of it. Get you a little bit of Worcestershire. I can do this left-handed probably. We'll try it out. Okay? Get you just about a tablespoon, teaspoon, half a teaspoon in there. Just whatever looks good for you. Once we get it to this point, what we're going to do is we're going to take all this meat. Use a little work area here. Throwing onions and meat out, so get back on here. Now, this goes without saying, once you finish mixing up a batch, what you need to do is sterilize your counter because you don't want cross-contamination. I do use Lysol, Clorox, whatever they are, wipes that have bleach in them. So, all right, what we're going to do, you need to get us a little bit of parchment paper. We're going to set it over here. Now, funny thing is, a lot of people go into Walmart, and they go into some of these other big box stores, Costco, and they complain about buying meat in a tube because they can't tell what kind of meat's in there. You don't know, you're getting cloven hooves or whatever with it. But anyway, what I'm going to do, because I got this meat and I know what's in it, I'm actually going to pour that on my parchment paper here. All right, looks like a big old meatloaf, don't it? Now I'm gonna shape it just a tad bit. I'm gonna shape it while it's in the parchment paper so it looks like a loaf. And there's a reason why I'm doing this, because we're gonna talk about patty size, because size means everything. I don't care what anybody tells you, size does matter. So we want to be sure we want to get this perfectly set up here. All right. So we're just going to wrap it up. Leave the ends open. That's okay. We're going to put it over here on our tray. And we're going to put it in the refrigerator. Let it cool down. We'll get some more meat. And we'll make our second batch. All right, so we're back for the second batch that we're going to make. of our hamburger mixture for the perfect hamburger. And once again, we'll just breeze through pretty quickly here. I've got the mixture of ground beef that I enjoy. Now I'm adding a couple of extra spices into the mix today. And there's a lot of other spices that you can add to it. Preferably for me, we're gonna stick with smoky paprika. We're gonna go with the garlic pepper, kosher salt. Now I'm actually gonna add some garlic cloves in here. Give a little extra oomph. And to get it that right spice, I'm gonna use my secret blend of herbs and spices. You can call me the Colonel from now on, or Scooter, whichever one you like. But I go for Tony Chachere's Creole spices. And the reason why I go for this is because it's got the right blend of all the different peppers. It's got cayenne pepper in it, it's got black pepper, it's got some chili powder in there, it's got dehydrated garlic to emphasize a little bit of that garlic. Has a bit of touch of salt, and it's got red peppers in there. So like those little peppers you like to sprinkle on your pizza because it tastes so good. And then it's got this other stuff in here. I think it gives an added kick to the hamburger. It's called silicone dioxide. Yeah, that just puts them out and it goes to the moon with them. And we're also going to go with our, you saw me do them earlier, but I've got my onions here that we sauteed. They're going to be delicious. We're going to add them to the mix. So it's real simple. Get them popping. I'm going to actually step over here and I'm going to heat up my onions for just a second. As it adding these in here, warming them up, it's going to get that butter that I sauteed them in, and it's going to add some extra delicious moisture to these hamburgers. No. And I got me an extra pair of gloves because I don't think the two are going to be enough. Let's get this big old honking chunk of meat in here and we'll get to mixing. Same thing applies on this one. Don't play with your meat too much. I cannot overemphasize that. Make sure it's cold. Some garlic, about a tablespoon worth. For all you're thinking, I'm thinking just a smidge, but it's gonna be delicious. All right, then we're gonna throw in all of our onions here. We got sauteed. All right, look at all that good looking stuff. All right. Then, as I always say, all you gotta do, just play with your meat for a little bit. For all you people who like a little burger with a bite, we're gonna get some Tony Chachere's in here, the original Cajun Creole seasoning. Alright? Now, not gonna go too heavy with this because this stuff, man, it'll light you on fire if you're not careful. Now, this goes without saying, but you know, in my younger days when I was immature, I didn't do a lot of this, but playing before you do this stuff can make it much more fun. That way you're not running around trying to find parchment paper when you got your meat marinating in all them seasons and everything here. So, we're going to get the parchment paper out. Tell you what, we're going to get this all looking like a big old meatloaf. Oh man, I can smell that. That smells good. Boy, if we had smell-o-vision, this would be awesome. Mm-hmm. All right, I'm just going to kind of loaf it up, because what we're going to do, once it has time to set up and cool, we're going to take it out and we're going to pat it. Something we're going to talk about next, patty size. What size patty do you want? There's a mixed school out there. And there's even some strange folks too, but generally a patty-sized people want their patty to fit on their bun. I mean, that's pretty much standard. Me, myself, I like a little bit of patty hanging over the bun, because you don't want to show all the buns. You want a little bit of patty and meat in there. Mm-hmm. So, we'll go over patty size when we get them out. So we're going to let this set up, rest a little bit in the refrigerator, and we're going to patty it. And I've got a couple ideas about what to do when you're pattying it, so you get the perfect burn.
Oh. That's right here. Casa de Scooter, we got some fire going. We're going to get them burgers out here in a little bit, and we're going to make you the perfect burger. Stay tuned.
We have chilled the meat sufficiently. Got them here in these two big old logs. Now, we're going to make some patties with these bad boys today. I'm going to get them rolled out here. Then I roll them into a log. Oh, looking at that big old meat log. Whoa, that looks good. All right, so we're gonna squeeze it down a little bit. It's got all that good flavor in it. Now this one's my one that's got my caramelized onions in it. Mm-hmm. There we go. So what we're gonna do with it now, there's a lot of debate about what the right size of a patty is. My perfect patty, and I'm going to show you right here, is about 1 inch thick. And in fisherman's words, it's 1 inch thick by about 4 to 5 inches in depth. So we're about 4 to 5 inches here. So I'm going to cut these down a little bit in bigger than 1 inch so we can flatten them out. Same rules apply here. Don't play with your meat too long. We're gonna get them cut, and then we're gonna get them flattened out, and we're gonna do something else to them. I'm gonna show that to you in just a second. So we're gonna go. So, big idea here, when you make your patty, don't flap them too much, because they're going to fall apart on you. You want to keep that fat content in there so it will hold the meat together when you're cooking it. Now, the big trick here, it's over here so you can see. Now, when you're making the patty, flatten it out. Now, you dimple it in the middle. So, you bring the inside down, because you know what's going to happen? Your meat's going to rise when it gets hot.
Mm-hmm.
Just telling you. You flatten it down in the middle. You got about a nice little French patty. Mm-hmm. All right. Just make it look like it will run around. And you set that over to the side. We're going to do that for the rest of these. Here are going to be some honking patties. Now, granted, you're going to have some shrinkage. Don't worry about it. That's just normal, everyday kind of thing. A little bit of shrinkage ain't going to hurt. So. I got to give some props to my cameraman, Scooty. He's doing a fantastic job. See, look at that. It's like, oh, boy, that's got a little hole. There. That works. Throw this over the top, because this is non-stick parchment paper. That's the other thing. Be prepared. I use non-stick parchment paper. And that way, meat don't stick to other things that you don't want to. And ladies and gentlemen, that That's how you make your perfect patties. Remember, dimple them. Don't handle your meat too often. You don't want to warm it up too much because that fat content in there won't bind. And it won't be as delicious. It'll be like eating a hockey pie. We're going to put these back in the refrigerator. We're going to let them cool down. So when we go onto the grill, they're going to be fantastic.
All right. Now we're at the most crucial part of the afternoon. We're going to grill some of the best burgers you've ever tasted. So we're going for the perfect burger, perfect size, perfect moisture. Now, typically, a hamburger, to get it to medium well, somewhere in between 145, 160, 165, takes about 4 or 5 minutes. And you can see here, we had our temperature. We're going up to over 500. So we've got plenty of heat going through here. You can see the smoke wafting out. So it's going to caress and love those hamburgers. So they're going to be meaty, juicy, delicious, and smoky. So I'm going to go ahead and get the burgers on the grill. Now, a little known fact about Scooter is that for whatever reason, some years back, don't know why, don't know how, but some nerves in my hands, for some reason, they went away. So I got not a lot of feeling in the palms and the tips and the pads of my hands. So I can reach in there and I can move stuff around and I don't really feel it. But the problem that you run into, and my ex-wife learned this, is that if I'm not careful, I'll sear the skin and you'll smell the skin burning before I'll notice that it's actually burning. So we're gonna try not to do that. All right. Now, I'll go ahead and close the lid down. Look at that smoke coming out of there, looking good. All right, so it's gonna take about 2 or 3 minutes to sear one side and we're gonna flip it. Now there's a debate going on about how many times you flip a burger. And I am of the school that you flip it as many times as you want to make sure it gets done. Because it's not like a steak. It's a hamburger. It's all ground up. So you want to make sure it gets cooked thoroughly all the way through. Now we dimpled them, so we're going to get even cooking as they swell. But we're going to let this smoke and grill for a minute. And we're going to come back here and we're going to take a look at them and flip them around. And we're going to have some delicious burgers here after a bit. Now we're getting the perfect amount of flame and smoke on the burger. They are just about done. All right, so we got the burgers on the grill. We got a couple more added on there, but we are approaching perfect temperature on these burgers. You can see the 167, it's medium well, juicy, delicious, wonderful. Now let's start taking them off. Okay, so it's the moment of truth. I'm Scooter, and this is...
I am Spanky.
That's Spanky right there. Spanky. We got the Spankettes. Just a couple of them. They ran out on me. I think they heard my cooking may not be that good. But anyway. So we got... Oh, yeah. And we have the lovely and talented... Miss Spanky.
Hi.
All right, so not much. She's kind of shy. So...
All
right. We're getting the burgers all lathered up, and we're going to, this is the moment of truth. We're going to test it. I'm sorry. And I got little Scooty with me, too.
I do not exist.
Say hi, Scooty.
Do not perceive me.
So this is the spanking, what are we going to call this? The spank mansion.
This is the spank adobe.
Ooh. Ooh, we're gonna get a bite here. Oh, I'm seeing one. Got two.
That's good.
Let's make a meal, you think?
Any other bite, just to make sure.
Like three more bites.
Yeah.
So Denver, what do you think, man?
Turn
out. You don't want to chew on that? Come on. Quentin, did I do okay?
Yeah.
You're just saying that. Because you're a very awesome. Polite young man.
Bring more.
All right. Thank you, everybody, for joining us today. It has been a simple and wonderful delight. We're cooking the best burgers in town. We made it through all the way to the end of episode 2, and I want to give up some props to Mr. and Mrs. Spanky and the Spankettes, and my personal favorite, Scooty, who's my clone. There you go. Running the camera for us today. Thank you to everybody that watched this. Give it a shot. I'll put the recipes on the website so you guys can try some of these spice combinations. And I wholeheartedly suggest that you get out there and you try some barbecue, try some hamburgering, try some fun out in this beautiful, oppressive heat that we have in this country today. But enjoy yourselves. Drink a cold beer, cold Dr. Pepper in my case. And just remember, we love you. Take care from the Backyard Gourmet. Have a wonderful day.